I am a real estate developer, owned a construction company for a while, sold that, and then got into storage units, iron gate self storage, and then realized that all the heavy real estate I was a part of was starting to have problems in our economy. 3 or 4 years ago, it started being pretty apparent to me, and decided I need to get in manufacturing because I'm not going to just sit back and let the problems just pile up. So I took action, found a business, created a list of what I wanted my business to be. Like, I actually went to Purdue and went through the school in engineering to do this. And then when I got out of the school, I didn't use any of it. I went into real estate. But now here I am, kind of coming full circle back into manufacturing and manufacturing. So I came across the business, was able to purchase the business, and it's a manufacturing business that we do chemical etching. I know nothing about chemical etching before I bought the business, but I figured I could learn. And one thing I found most unique about this business was that the gentleman was retiring, and that he was an order taker. He didn't market. He did pay for AdWords. It was the only thing he did, Google AdWords, but he basically just took orders. So I bought his list. The true value was the list. Now, I will tell you that banks don't think there's much value in that. So they won't put collateral against the list. And that's a struggle when it comes to buying. And that's the most unique thing between real estate and asset purchases like that. Getting off topic, when I bought the business, right off the bat, I wanted to come up with something unique to market the business. And we do chemicals that we etch different alloys, stainless steel, copper, brass, and nickel, silver are our most common. So some of the scrap that we use, in a mastermind that I was in with John, we came up with an idea, let's make a business card out of some of my scrap and use that as my calling card. And so this is the card that we designed and created, and on the card it actually has the parts, some of our products that we offer. So it's a card, it's a sample, it is all the different types of etching we do. We do full etch, half etch, raised etch. We do a lot of braille work for the New York subway, so there's some of the raised etching in here. And the point of this is that it was a unique enough sales piece that it offers a lot of powers. Number one, when I did go to a conference, let's say, and I was cold calling people, I could get the topic of me trying to sell them. I could transfer that awkwardness of, hey, I'd like to have your business and I want to date you, but before I date you, here, this is this card. Then we got to talking about the card, and it totally transformed the whole process of the awkwardness of, well, I'll give you a call and, you know, you give me a quote. It was more like, let's talk about this card. Oh, wow, these are interesting parts, and I'm not going to throw this away. I don't see this type of calling card very often. And as it, one guy actually said, I'm an artist. And this was at a radio frequency technology, military technology conference I was at. And this guy happened to be an artist that was there working for his mother's business. So he was making money on the side. His passion was art. He said, I'm going to keep your card, I might be able to use it. And I said, okay, that's fine. We do some art, we do jewelry, we do models. So maybe this would work out. 6 months ago, he called me and said, I've got a project for you. I've been commissioned, this is the artist now. He said, I've been commissioned to do a cross for the World Trade Center tragedies at St. Peter's Cathedral, which is just across the street from the site. And I'd like you to build me a book of all the names that of the deceased, the victims, they say, of that tragedy. And the book will be made out of stainless steel, and it'll be as many names as you can get on a page, and as many pages as it takes. And this will sit at the base of this cross forever and ever, and would you be interested? And I said, absolutely. Not only that, I'll try and do it for as minimal cost as possible, if not for free. So I went out, called my vendors, was able to acquire most of the materials and services for basically free. We have a little bit of expense in it, but not nearly as much. And he built the cross, we came up with the book. I also then went back to him, and we've dialogued a lot since then about, well, let's go to the Pentagon. They need to have a book of names. And so does the location in Pennsylvania where the airplane crashed. They need a book of names. And then the firehouses, they're gonna need books. It's not necessarily a book you would read, but more like a living memorial that would sit in their firehouse as a reminder to them and as an awareness. Geez, of our freedom. So the long story short is, this is all coming to fruition last week. No, 2 weeks ago, the cross made its way across the country from San Diego. It's going to New York City. It stopped by our office, and we had a marriage, if you will, of our book to his cross, and then the cross was stood up, and we had local dignitaries there, the fire department, the police department, and everybody. It was just an awesome experience to see this cross. Then we took the cross to a Catholic school that my kids go to in Elkhart, St. Thomas, and all the little kids got to see this. Now, most of these kids actually they weren't even born when this happened. So to them, this is history. And the point that this cross will never be in Elkhart again, it's going to New York, and it will be there for the rest of our lives. It was a really unique experience. We got some local press on it. We're doing a press release when we get ready to go out, which is actually the 14th of July, we'll be there. So I won't be at next month's meeting. We'll be there ahead of time, prepping the site and getting ready for the unveiling at that location. And it's really gonna be special. And the reason why he called me, because I had this business card, and he made the story that I didn't prompt him to say, is that when he got our card, my card, he put it away. He couldn't throw it away at the show because he just didn't want to get rid of it. It stayed in his desk and it kept moving around, and he kept clearing his desk and it kept getting in the way. And he just didn't want to get rid of it because it was different and unique. And he said that was the reason he called me when he finally had this cross scenario came to him, and then he thought about the book below. So little unique things like this can make a big difference in your business. And I think this is going to spin off into gobs of all kinds of other opportunities for metal. We're calling it now Metal Book Memories. We're doing a landing page for this. So when we have the presentation, people will go to our website, find us, and we're going to start coming up with other scenarios to create, to memorialize other events in steel, which for us is great because it's low tolerance, which means I can blast these plates through the chemicals at a fast pace, make better money than the high precision stuff that I got to make four sheets to get one good one, because they're going into missiles and the satellites and all
so
that.
So yeah,
stuff.
I mean, a couple things that I wanted Dan to tell you about, it was that, you know, he has this opportunity, he's doing this book, which is super unique. I mean, just, you know, he's talked about this before, that he's doing this with 9/11, which is fantastic, and I think we can all resonate that. What was really cool, I couldn't be there, but he said a couple weeks ago they came, and Dan, what he's not taking as much credit for as he should, he did a really good job of getting the press there. He had made an actual event out of it. Then he went over to the St. Thomas School and did another event there. And hopefully, you know, I know you've got video of
yep.
it. So you'll have the video posted on your website, now on YouTube,
Facebook.
And, you know, Facebook and all that kind of stuff. So he's doing all these different things. So Dan is a super implementer, and he's done all that. Now, he's taken this little opportunity, and could be just a one thing, just do this one book, metal book, which is really cool. But now it's going way, way out. It's going to be a huge opportunity for him. And when we talked about the first thing in Mastermind Group, is like, hey, Dan, can we sell more of these books? What do you have the rights to this? So he obtained the rights to it. He can make these metal books and sell them. And now I think the real challenge for you is how you monetize this thing. So far you're not really making any money off the deal.
No.
But event, you know, what we can do is sell these books, and you know, these books could be sold for $10,000.
But like you just said earlier, what I am doing is using this story with all of my customers.
Exactly.
So now when I call them, I'm not selling them. I'm telling them our story about something unique. And oh, by the way, Indiana Micro Metal Etching is here to, you know, do all your business and more. And we're getting more leads. But I'm not really asking for the sale. I'm just telling them about events that are happening.
Yes.
In our
it's going to be a big, big thing.
We're
sure.
We're already into firehouses too.
There
we got a couple already that are wanting them. So
anyway, good. It's really neat stuff. It really.